Here's an example of what Galileo's data may have looked like. So in this version of the experiment, he ran through the experiment 5 times. In the first run through, when he allowed the ball to roll 1 unit of time, he measured a distance of 1 unit. After 2 units of time, he got 4.03. 3, 9.07, and 4, 16.18. Now, he was a good scientist, so of course he repeated this process multiple times, and this is the data he got in each of those following repetitions. Now, with all of this wonderful data, now he has to analyze it. But how does he take advantage of the fact that he's collected each piece of data multiple times? Presumably, he wants to find patterns in this data, but how does he use all of it? He's collected it, he should use it all. Well, the answer is he takes the average. And so I'll quickly review what an average is in case you've forgotten or if you don't know. To calculate an average, so for example, if I want to calculate the average distance rolled in each of these units of time, and I've indicated average distance by a D with a bar over it, and in physics a bar over a letter generally means the average, what I'm going to do is add up all of my data and divide by the number of data points. So here I would add up 1.00 plus 1.01 plus 0.99 plus 0.99 plus 1.01. Divided by 5, because that's how many data points I have, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And when I calculate that, well, I get an average of 1.00. Can you calculate the average for the other 3 time measurements? Enter your answers in these 3 boxes.